Support the Terrible Warriors today by visiting patreon.com/terriblewarriors. Ravenloft is a cursed land. Those who enter it can't leave. Those who search for it will never find it. Time has no meaning. Maps, pointless. And so our adventurers trapped in this realm take a job, 'cause adventurers gotta eat. But things have not gone well. The child they were sent to rescue, they were too late. And after returning her body to the castle, they are trapped. And one thing is certain, a whisper in the ear, that if they can't escape, they'll be dead by dawn's light. Mike the Birdman Dodd gathers his players together one more time with Cassie, Scotty, Justin, and Connell. And together, our hapless adventurers trapped in a realm they will never escape. They are your Terrible Warriors.
Welcome back to Terrible Warriors. I am your Dungeon Master, Master of the Mists, Mike the Birdman Dodd from ThisWeekInGeek.net. And I am not alone, as we are trapped inside a hidden haunted keep in the forests of the Slavic Woods in the lands of Barovia. You know them as Ravenloft.
Trapped in the realm, trapped in the forest, trapped in the keep, trapped in the hall. It's like a babushka doll of traps. To get out of one, you can't get out of the other.
Those Russian nesting dolls.
Yeah, the matryoshka dolls.
I hate this place.
Hate this job.
It's all your fault, Calder.
Why is it this fault?
I don't know. I need to blame someone. I'm going to rage. I rage. I'm Justin Eacock.
I rage in the darkness. Now.
better known on the Terrible Warriors as Justin Eacock.
Look at me!
Hey! Camp 2!
Is he gonna rage against the darkness? Can do! Ooh, he's trying!
Your ability to roll dice doesn't determine your worth as a person! You are a wonderful player character just the way you are!
What the fuck?
I'm Scott.
I'm normal.
And I'm fucking normal.
Oh my god. Nice to meet you, normal. Thanks for coming out today.
He's fucking normal. What's up?
It is my personal plan to go as a Mr. Meeseeks to Magfest.
Oh god.
Do it.
And every time anyone asks me to do something, I go, can do! And then just run out of the room. But over the course of the 4 days, I'm gonna, dirty up the costume and be like, existence to my kind is a torture.
I just want to die. For too long. Things are getting real weird. Anyways, my name is Connell Macbeth, better known in the nerd community as Toronto's greatest supervillain and evil genius, Dr. Terawatt.
And I'm Cassidy 20 Love Chew, and I am terrified of what's to come.
So, when last we left, there was strobing lights in this keep hall, and there is a tiny ghost girl getting closer and closer to us. This isn't Space Jam. Okay.
But what if it is?
It's like the fucking Ring.
All right, so.
All we gotta do is call Bugs Bunny. He'll help us.
We return. The lights in the hall come up a little bit. You can basically, it's just barely above candlelight, where you can't really see more than 10 feet in front of you, but there is a little bit of light. Almost as if the light's trying to fight back against the darkness, but even it knows it's going to lose.
Okay, I'm going to try to, at this point, see if my magic works. Use prestidigitation to try to light some of the candles.
You can light one or two, but you can't seem to muster any more magic. You try and put a lot more mojo behind it. Nothing.
Oh, man, yeah, so you see Calder, extend his hands out, and, you see him exert a lot of energy, and a couple of candles flicker on. It's like, and even then the candles are kind of, flickering.
Well, I don't have to worry too much about magic. I just want to hit the ghost with my hammer.
Don't hit the kid. I think we should apologize.
Maybe we should give a bracelet back.
So for those people at home listening, Connell just very dramatically gestured his arm over at Scotty, yeah, maybe that's a good fucking idea.
Maybe you should do that. You fuck?
Yeah. Maybe next game, who knows?
Maybe worth something.
Maybe. There's a nice jewel.
Well then, fucking throw it!
Okay! Just,
tell me what to do.
Put it on the ground, and say we're sorry.
Hey, so,
the stage is yours.
Okay.
Oh god. Oh, here it comes.
Why yes, fair ghost. You have...
Hark!
No!
Hark! I hear thou callest me!
I'm William Shatner, I felt in that.
What
but,
ghost
hey,
through
ghosty.
Yonder window breaks?
I have your bracelet, which you may take.
Can I just take the bracelet out of Salter's hand and just throw it at the ghost?
No.
No?
I want to present it as a non-violent act. Like that.
You open your hand, present the bracelet, and it's almost as if a pool of darkness appears in the air. This rotting hand comes out, takes the bracelet, pulls it back into the pool of darkness, and it just evaporates.
Okay. Well,
that was the only treasure we had.
So can we now live at dawn?
Dead
you
by midnight now.
Is the kid still
can
moving
we open
closer
the door?
To us slowly?
Is the door still locked?
Nope. The kid is gone.
The kid's gone.
Is the door unlocked?
Kid's gone.
Okay, try the door.
But you can hear other doors in the place unlocking.
Yes.
It's not the one behind you.
It's not the one behind us. Fuck!
Here's Thumper!
Fucking
on the door.
Stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it. We'll make our way through
I hate this
to
keep.
Wherever this... We'll make
so
our way
if you go off to your left, it goes into more hallways into the castle. There is the lower half. There's also the upper half, which you presume that's typically where you'd find people of higher stature. That's where their quarters would be if there's a court wizard or a sorcerer.
Okay.
Typically, that's where you'd find their kind of libraries and whatnot.
Okay, so...
So in other words, who's to blame? It will be up
well,
there.
Because is that the direction we heard the unlocking from?
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to head that way then. I'm going to do what I can to try and use my cantrip light on the crystal that's around my neck to sort of give us a flashlight and see if that works. Does it?
Yes,
I also
it
have
works.
A hooded
it's
lantern.
Working.
I have a hooded lantern.
Light it.
Yeah. Dodd, that cool? I've got the tinder and everything. So I have the... So the lantern has the sort of the hood on the front so I can direct the light in a specific direction. So it's the closest thing you get to a flashlight.
The aperture.
Yeah, it's like what you'd have in a mine shaft. Yeah. So I'll have that as well with you so we can be looking in a couple directions.
Okay, good. So I'm not the only source of light. And we'll make our way towards the sound.
We just need our two
library
perception people keeping an eye out for what I'm looking for.
Mage's archive.
Okay. I do not know that it would be wise for me to be up in the front because I am still injured.
Yeah, but you can hang out just behind me and keep a perception.
Yes.
Because I'm not going to notice what you notice.
I can and will do that.
I will be behind, okay, so the order would be Thumper first, and then Ophelia, then myself, and do you want to hold up the rear?
That way nothing sneaks up behind
Scotty?
Us.
Scotty?
Yeah.
Salshar's holding up the rear?
That's right.
Goddamn right.
All right, so that's our marching order, and we're just making our way towards... The Sorcerer's Library.
Dun, dun,
dun. All right, so you start heading up the stairs. You start passing through a huge hallway. There are tons of, like, display cases. Hmm. You see, like, swords and jewelry and what looks like scrolls and books in them.
Don't
you
touch.
Eventually see a giant door at the end of the hallway.
Okay. Head down
once
towards...
Once again, light is struggling... to get more than 10 or 15 feet
even the
ahead
natural
of you.
Light of the lantern, eh?
Pardon?
Even the natural light of the lantern.
Even the natural lantern. Light of the lantern seems to be somewhat suppressed.
Okay, so then, yeah, no.
It's like a
as...
bad Instagram filter on everything, just lowering the
well,
contrast.
Well, it's like, if you've seen the Silent Hill movie, it's like the fucking when the sirens go and everything gets really fucking dark. Like, you can light lights, but the light doesn't go more than a few feet tops. And then everything's just fucking spooky black out of that.
Who's in the front right now?
That would be moi.
Thumper with the lantern. As we're moving down
Thumper,
the hallway...
Thumper, can you roll me a reaction? Dexterity based.
Can do! Four.
Oh,
four?
No.
A four.
Okay. You... Just give me a sec, you're misreading
it's a
this.
Great sound.
Just regain. How much damage do you do?
Oh boy.
Okay. What are you wearing right now?
I'm wearing hide armor.
Wearing hide armor?
A shield, but I'm not. I don't have it out.
You got the fur lining. Nice fur lined hide armor.
Yeah, I'm wearing the fur cloak to keep warm, but really it's just the hammer crossbow hide armor.
And your big stupid hat.
And my big stupid hat. That is comfy as F.
Okay, you are taking 1d8 acid damage.
It was a ghost.
Okay. But the ranger didn't see this? You were supposed to be.
It drops from the ceiling. It looks like a pool of shadow.
Not on my new hat! No!
So your hat instantly dissolves.
No!
Are you wearing any weapons on your back?
It's just.
Oh. You gotta erase that off your character. Get the eraser ready.
Oh, this is worse than when the kid died.
Oh, okay.
Wait, I take that back immediately. All right, so sorry, how much damage am I taking on acid?
1d8, you're taking 3?
No,
three
I acid. Do.
Do you have any weapons out right now?
I have advantage against effects such as traps and spells as a dexterity saving throw with my danger sense.
Okay, roll it. Well,
I say, like, what did you roll previously?
It was the reaction.
And then roll one more time.
And then okay, we'll have you roll again because you're supposed to add that to your roll against the trap.
Okay, well that roll was a natural 19.
Right, you avoid it. Then.
So that would be that would have been my second roll. Okay. Cool. So that's okay, 21.
So, yeah. So what happened is you see this black pudding.
There's two timelines now. The terrible timeline is
missing. It starts hissing on the floor as it starts to dissolve through carpet.
Oh, okay. So there's this glob of shadow fell from the roof onto the floor and is dissolving now through the floor.
Yep, and now it's whipping out like these really thick, ropey pseudopods.
Ah! I take a 5-step back.
All right, you do as such. You are out of range of its pseudopods.
Pseudopods?
I'm going to back up as well. Because what the shit is this?
I
want
to throw alchemist fire at it.
I have watched enough anime to know where this is going.
To a sexy scene.
All right, Salchar, you're up.
Oh.
Speaking of sexy scenes. It's...
Oh, yeah, okay, I thought you... Yeah,
get in there and
make
charm
love
it.
To the slime. Charm the slime.
Cannot fuck the black pudding.
I intimidate the pseudopod. All right, are we just gonna walk around it?
Because it's got like little tentacles. It's trying to reach out and stuff. Does it move across the room at all?
It's almost as if it's guarding the door, but these things are non-intelligent.
Okay, so it's like this little like black ooze that sort of. Is it continuing to eat through the floor, or was it just the carpet it dissolved?
It's just eating through the carpet. It's leaving the stone underneath.
Gross. I'm going to shoot a firebolt at it.
Gross.
All right.
Gross. 25 to hit?
Yep, it hits.
Yeah, 25. Groovy, and then that's 2d10s. You, 2, kablam. 14 fire damage.
Okay, so you
blam.
You hit the pudding with a firebolt. It boils off a little bit of it. It doesn't seem too affected by it, however.
Damn it!
Don't hit it with your
you
weapons.
You now see
It'll
this thing reaching for you guys. So everybody, roll me initiative.
So why don't we just go through the wall instead of the door?
Because it's a hallway that leads to a door, and there's an ooze now in the way to get to the door.
All right, well, we're rolling initiative.
Roll initiative.
4.
13.
8.
23.
Who is in the back right now?
I am.
Salchar.
Salchar?
Yep.
Salchar, you feel a hand grasp your shoulder.
Eugene, Levy is one of my kitties. Please.
You are face-to-face with two ghouls.
Damn it.
You had one job, Salchar. One job.
And I messed it
up. Keep an eye on things sneaking up behind us.
I thought that there was someone behind me. Oh, no. Okay. So, well, I guess I will.
I can deal with ghouls. You can deal with weird black pseudopod magic sorcerer thing.
Thank you. Yes, that's my name.
Magic sorcerer.
I want to throw the alchemist fire at it so bad, but I also don't want to burn the whole keep down in the process.
Yeah, please don't do that.
I have five. We'll just throw all five.
So great if you could not.
All five.
Okay, so, well, I guess
the opening scene to like Phantom Pain with the whole hospital's on fire.
My God.
I'm trying to think.
We're in too close quarters for me to use fireball.
Oh, if we could have like a fire resistance spell, and I just throw the alchemist fire on.
I actually
you
am resistant to fire
into
damage.
Like a napalm man.
I'm resistant to fire damage. I'll just run in with it all.
Start bear hugging everyone while covered in alchemist fire goo.
Well, then I guess I'm gonna have to attack him unless I dash out of the way.
He's gonna get the first attack on you.
Yeah, the two ghouls.
Yeah, they're gonna.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the first one.
Got the jump.
I got the drop on you there.
It says the second one. Does a 17 hit you, Scott?
Yeah, my armor class is 13, so.
Oh, okay.
I'm on board.
Okay, then. So you take 2d4.
Come on, 2.
Oh, that's right. I can sacrifice.
Okay, Scott, take 5 damage and roll me a DC constitution, or a constitution check, DC 10.
Where's my D10? Oh, right here. So, I was rolling a D10, right? That's what you want me to roll?
No.
Oh, sorry.
No, yeah, you roll a D20, I'm looking for you to get a 10 or above.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Okay.
Yeah, I've got 16.
Okay, so you resist being paralyzed.
Sweet. But I have 5 damage down, right?
Yeah, but you have 5 damage. This thing rakes its dirty, grave-ridden claws across your armor.
Ew.
And you're a little bit taken back because the other one tried to swipe at you, but you were able to stumble back.
Gross.
Gross.
Okay, so going back to the front of the line... who got top order again? So it was Salchar.
I rolled a 23 on my initiative.
Okay.
I got 13.
Right, so you go first then.
All right, cool. So it just occurred to me, by the way, that, I have 2 attacks.
Yep.
So that
and
whole
also,
situation
depending
with
on
the
how you guys take this fight,
probably
you're flanked on both sides. Just keep this in mind.
That we are. There's 2 ghouls on one side of us and a dark ooze acid thing on the other side, so we got to be careful.
I hope it's not like a rust monster.
Yeah, no, don't try to hit it with your weapons. It'll and it's also pretty resistant to my magic, from what it seems.
I'm also behind on my tetanus shots. So.
Yeah, so it's
good. Damn it.
Okay, well, right. I mean, maybe not melee, but I got a bow I can shoot the slimy goo with.
Yep, you can do that.
It's a magic bow, too.
He's magic.
You'd be like, pip, pip.
And it's plus 11 to hit, so I don't see this being an issue.
Boop. That is a 23 to hit.
Yep, hits it for sure.
So that's first. Do you roll to hit both and then do damage after, or...
Do you want me to do that?
We'll do damage first.
Okay, then damage and then the second attack.
And that is 10 piercing.
Magic.
Okay, so the arrow shoots into the ooze. It absorbs it, but it definitely is hurt. You can hear, like, this really guttural squishing sound.
Okay.
That's
enough
good sound.
Out of 2 of you.
This is great. This is good. Okay, please step. Please.
All right. Second attack?
Second attack. Oh. Okay. I guess I'll go fuck myself then.
What'd you roll?
It's a natural one.
Oh my god. You
fuck
rolled
me,
a natural
right?
one.
Although no Ophelia so, like, making the same gurgling noise.
So, this is like the second one's like, I attempt to knock the arrow and fail at it. You're just like, oh, well.
Like, okay. Oops.
All right. The next in line.
What did you roll, Justin, for initiative?
For initiative? I think I rolled like a 6.
Okay, I rolled a 13, and Scotty, you got 2.
5. I rolled a 5.
Oh, you rolled a 5.
Yeah.
Okay, so then it'd be myself next, I believe. Yeah.
Go.
All right. So as a free action, I'm gonna spend one of my first level spell slots to regain 2 of my sorcerer points, which I will then use to twin spell one of my scorching rays again. And I am going to just... I'm going to bury one of them into the ghoul, and if it's still standing, I'm going to bury the second one into it as well. If it's not, I'm going to turn fire onto the second. Is it okay if I just do the 1d20 for the first 6 rounds?
Sure.
Like, just so that we're not sitting here rolling all day? Just to make sure that's okay with you. Okay, come on. Do the thing! Okay, so 13 plus 8 is 25?
That's
21.
That's 21?
It's a 13 plus 8, right?
Yeah, yeah, 13 plus 8 is 21. 21. Is 21 a hit?
Yep.
Okay. Scotty, if I can borrow your dice.
Oh. For sure, friend. Two, four, what six, number shall we count to today?
Eight. Let's see, yeah, 1, 2, 3.
Did
four,
you do over 22?
6.
I'd like to do a montage of all the times Conwell has count up his dice in this entire Ravenloft storyline.
Pretty sure that's
That's over 22. Yeah, no.
It vaporizes.
I just like turn around.
Why are the
scorching ray fires out of your fingers? This thing literally
carry things and
glows red and then vaporizes into a pile of ash.
All right, so that's okay for the first one. Okay, and then, oh shit, dropped a percentile.
Good wham.
Ba-da-ba-da.
You did it.
Ba-da-ba-da, doobie-doo-bow. Okay. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. When attempting to fire his second shot, he freezes.
Oh.
Yep. He does not fire from his second spell. He panics and freezes up.
Why?
It is a roleplay thing I built into my sorcerer for my first game that I told Dot about. Every time I'm using my fire sorceries, I roll percentile. If I get above 50, I go. If I get below 50, he panics.
Shit.
Ugh.
Yeah.
That sucks.
So,
I like that though.
Yeah,
so yeah, just you like, just
I,
feel
I built
the
that
fear
in,
of
so,
the flame build in you, and you're like, oh god, I just did that to a living creature.
Yeah, no, you just like vaporizing one of the ghouls brought back some really terrible memories, and he locks up.
Should all
right, next in line.
Next in line.
That's pretty serious.
So is this time for Thumper to grab Calder and start slapping? Get your act back together!
You well, because that's the thing, is you see him, like, turn around and just, like, blah, 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 like 6 fucking heat beams shoot out of his hand and just annihilate one of these ghouls, and he, like, there's more energy, and he turns and stops.
So, legit question, can I use Intimidate to help you get through this block?
I don't know, we'll see. Do you want to attack something or try to intimidate?
Well, I don't think I'm going to be much help against the isopods.
Hit the ghoul with your hammer.
I can rage and go against the ghoul with the hammer, no problem.
Go for it.
But I was thinking I'd much rather grab you by the cuff and slap you back into... Okay, I'll do that next round.
Okay.
I'm going to move through the group dot to the back of the line, to the ghouls. And as I'm doing that and I'm running towards them, I rage. Because of course
all
I
right,
do.
All right, you do as such.
And, and I think it's here, Frenzy... You can go into a frenzy for the duration of your rage when you choose to. You go into a frenzy when you do the rage. Bonuses on your turn after. Attack bonus on each of your turn after this one. So I am going to frenzy, but the frenzy reaction won't happen until round 2.
Roger that.
So for now, but there is reckless attack, which is done on your first turn. Doing so gives you advantage on melee weapon attack rolls using strength, but attack rolls against you will have advantage until your next turn. I'm going to do that because that's going to give me my bonus die right now.
Yep.
So I'm going to use my reckless attack, and I'm going to rage, so that's going to give me 2 attacks, each of them at advantage.
V the ghoul.
Plus my damage attacks if I land any of them. So
let's do this.
These 2 and these 2 red die and the blue. So these are match. These are match. So critical on the 1 on my first attack, and on my second attack it's a 17.
Does a 17
they
hit the
both
ghoul?
Hit.
The 17 hits, and on the critical hit. Because I have savage attacks, when you score a critical hit with a melee weapon,
oh my god,
you can roll 1 of the weapon's damage dice an additional time and add it to the extra damage of the critical hit.
Wow.
So, with a 2-handed warhammer, I believe that's a d12.
Well, yeah, what's it say on your cheat? You should
have
read
it. Oh, well, I only have one D8. I don't have the type for, because it's versatile.
Oh, you need a D12?
Oh, I have a D12. I was just confirming that it goes out to a D12. So, for the first attack, that's, how do critical attacks work
I'm
in
looking that,
fifth
I'm,
edition?
I've already been looking that up.
Is it just the maximum dice roll?
Critical hits on page 196. So let's have a look.
The extra damage of the critical hit, but I'm adding an additional die.
196, you said?
Yes.
I'm almost there.
Critical hits. When you score a critical hit, you get to roll an extra dice for the attack's damage against the target. Roll all of the attack's damage twice and add them together. Then add any relevant modifiers as normal. To speed up play, you can roll all the damage dice at once. So basically, if you crit something, for example, if you score a critical hit with a dagger, roll 2d4 for the damage rather than 1d4.
So instead of 1d12, it becomes 2d12, but because of savage attacks, it becomes 3d12.
Yes, and then you add your usual modifiers
plus,
as normal.
Which becomes plus 5. So 2d12 plus 5.
2d12 plus 5, yeah, or 3d12 plus 5 now because of your fucking rage barbarian ability.
That's on your crotch. That doesn't count. That's on the floor.
You have crotch die back.
Crotch die.
Okay, so.
It didn't roll very high.
That's, the crotch die was low. 7 plus 17 plus 13. 13 plus 17 is 37. 37.
Holy fuck.
You cleave the ghoul in half.
No, that's not, it's a warhammer. I crushed him like a can.
Yeah, just like
a pumpkin.
Turn
just
around and annihilate
this thing.
Yeah,
turned into a bloody pulp.
Over 3 hits, just poosh, poosh, poosh.
Oh yeah, like you are covered in gore. You are quite the sight to see.
And next round, I'm going to go into frenzy. That was my first hit. There's two ghouls, right?
No, the other one
the other one
they're both dead.
Okay, well, what do I do with my second attack? That
just
was a 17.
Go after
the pudding.
Pudding
if you want.
It's on the other end of the room, though. I'd have to run over. I guess my two attacks. Yeah. I just start pounding it again.
Yeah, so you just like keep wailing on the mush.
And
all right, Scotty.
Scotty.
Alrighty,
that's
I guess
why
I
you
shall.
Bring a barbarian into a haunted keep.
So I guess I shall. The ghouls are gone. So I think. You did damage to the sauropod thing with your longbow, right?
Yes.
Okay, so I will. Oh wait, mine's not magic though. I don't have a magic on my crossbow.
Shoot at it anyways.
You said I don't have to worry about them having it.
Yeah, you know. Yeah, I'll try it anyways. Who knows?
Worst case scenario, you lose a bolt.
Yeah, whatever. Okay, so I'm going to.
I've got 100.
I have 17 bolts already loaded into the crossbow, so I'm going to take a few out and put them back in my backpack because I got a little overzealous. And I'm going to shoot this guy. Oh.
is this the first time you've shot the crossbow?
Yeah, it is.
It's like 7 months.
What'd you roll?
You've never fired a crossbow.
Roll total of 9?
You hit.
Whoa!
Oh, yeah!
This is like the end of Evangelion. Everyone's just making congratulations. 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 So I got my
right, so your crossbow bolt fires out of your crossbow, hits this thing.
I got
it. It takes the hit, but it definitely is hurt.
Okay.
Well, how much damage do you do?
Let's see where we go from
roll
there.
Roll your damage.
Okay, we're going to count. God damn it. 2.
He rolled 1.
2 total.
Are you including your dexterity bonus in that?
Yeah.
Yep.
I'm including my damage bonus. Is that with
his
that?
His damage bonus is 1.
Yeah.
So is that 3 then? I didn't include dexterity in that. So it's 3. That's better than 2. It's 3.
Oh, no, because wait, your damage bonus is plus 1, right?
Yeah.
And your dex bonus is also plus 1. Yeah, that's your dex bonus there. That's the.
Oh, okay.
So it is a total max damage.
The first time you fired your crossbow in this campaign and hit something, and it is the most uninspiring, underwhelming thing.
We all can't have flame cannons and evaporate people and be like,
hey, you know what?
So Calder is just Heat Man.
I am
all
right, Heat Man.
So the pudding's gonna go now.
Oh, it's the pudding's turn.
Of the fire!
Who would be closest to it in theory if it's at the end of the hallway?
That would be Ophelia and myself.
Well, I backed off quite a bit, though.
It's gonna go after Ophelia.
Right up to to the ghouls, and Salchar...
I was at the ghouls, so...
He was at the ghouls.
Me. So you came when you were...
I was at the ghouls.
Did you move closer to it to shoot
no.
at the thing?
No.
Right, no, but so then, he was now, already in the back of the
so
party,
then it,
so...
Then it actually, it would put... Ophelia was behind me in the marching order before I moved back.
I'm guessing a 21 hits you.
And she also moved back, so it'd be me.
It's you.
All right, Calder, yes. Does a 21 hit you?
It does!
Okay,
oh,
then.
Boy!
You take 1d6.
Oh, boy!
I didn't see that one coming.
Again, what's dude. In
you take 6 damage.
Oh, yeah.
Plus... No, that's just the bludgeon. Uh-huh. So that's from the force of this thing. So it doesn't hit you very hard.
Whap.
But...
You just slap.
It does hit you with...
A love tap.
4d8 acid damage.
Jesus!
Ah!
So, 16 acid damage.
Oh,
wow. Boy! Well, that actually could have been a lot worse than it
that
was.
Could have been
so
way
that
worse.
Is okay. So 16 plus another 6 bludgeoning.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's 22 damage.
Yep.
Are you wearing any armor?
Nope. I've got padded armor on, the cloth armor
I've
got.
It is now partially dissolved.
Oh, fuck.
It's like, basically, you just got hit by, like, alien acid blood.
Gross!
Think of that scene in Aliens. It starts hissing and popping.
Ew!
Actually, Connell, I want you to roll me a dexterity save. I'm looking for 15 or higher.
Oh, fuck. 12. Wait, no, hold on. Fucking... No, I don't have enough fucking sorcerer points. I can't do Tides of Chaos and
you
give myself
spent it
a minute.
On the owlbears.
I did. I fucking blew my bend luck on owlbears. Well, okay, so I didn't make it. What happens?
Your bag of holding dissolves.
No! So just everything that was inside
we should have left the body
out.
In there. Oh, it was spilled out, yeah.
Yeah, so all the things that are inside of it spill out onto the floor.
So yeah, the basically the... The black pudding's pseudopod rips across the bag of holding.
Hold on,
everything
like a
just
boat
spills
now,
out
like...
across the floor.
It goes bleh next to me.
Did you have any alchemist fire in there?
Oh.
Yes, I had 5 alchemist fires in there.
Roll them.
I'm resistant to fire damage, so that's alright.
All of them? That is 5d4.
Are we rolling for the chance to see if they break?
Yeah, because they weren't thrown, they were dropped.
Oh, they broke.
Good thing I have fire.
It's so great.
There's a lot of stuff in that bag that's all spilling out. So
it's
don't
so great. I spent all that money on something that just kills me in the end.
This is what the DM does, though. You can't have good things.
No, I know. You can't have nice things.
No, right, but you're going to want to hear
more
this
D4.
When you roll it. What's the total damage?
You need some, yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm gonna need some
Here's
more D4s.
One.
You got another one?
I think that's
good,
what I got.
I need one more.
D4s?
You got D4 over there and another Caltrop.
They look like Caltrops.
Yeah, you take that. Here we go. Whoosh. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 damage. And
even tinier Caltrops.
I am now on fire.
Nope, actually you are not.
Oh no?
The black pudding takes it.
Oh, did all my stuff...
It spilled out, rolled across the floor, and the Valkyrie's fire rolled right into...
Oh,
right
okay. It's 250 gold worth of shit. Damn it.
Plus well, at least it got hit.
Okay, did the rest of my stuff roll into the fucking fire, though?
Not all of it, but some okay. of it.
And a lot of gold is now lying on the ground as well.
Where is the deck?
Oh, that I didn't put in the bar, in the bag.
Okay.
The deck of many things, my ring, and a couple of my other important stuff I kept on myself.
Just wanted to check that.
Yeah, no, so that's Alchemist Fire is gone.
Because imagine if that fell out, and then, like, one card fell out.
Did the Potion of Healing survive it? Well, if it fell on the floor, then
high
it would've...
Low.
It'd have broke. If the Alchemist Fire broke, then the Potion would've broke.
Okay.
Climbing kit. Tinderbox.
Tinder, swipe right.
My net, the antitoxin vial. What about the money? Did the money roll in, or we're gonna say
it's scattered across the hallway?
So 20 to so out of the 400 GP, about half of that.
Probably, yeah.
All right, cool.
And a big wad of molten gold.
The tent would. All right, cool. Molten so gold. I have
gold bullion.
I have my rations.
It becomes yeah.
I have my rations, my caltrops, and my 200 gold.
Savage.
And my armor's AF. And my armor's buggered.
You're just having a great day.
Can't do.
So make sure to adjust your armor class after this fight.
Yep. No, that goes down by one, so I'm down to 12.
I mean, you can have my hide armor.
I can't cast with it.
Yeah, because I was actually doing the math. I think my armor class goes up if I don't wear the armor.
It's possible.
Like with the armor, my AC's at 18, but according to this, if I... Armor class 10 plus dexterity plus constitution plus shield is 19.
Yeah. So. I basically crossed off everything that was burnable or light or breakable, and that was pretty much everything except my caltrops and my rations and some of the money. Like climbing kit, tinderbox, bedroll, silk rope, net, antitoxin vial, potion of healing, climbing kit and spikes, my two-person tent.
This is why you shouldn't give in to material possessions.
Well, there it is. Right. Whatever.
So it's the top of the combat order, so guess Ophelia's going first.
Back to me?
Yep.
So how's the goop? It's still going, even after old alchemist.
It's still on fire. It's still going.
Is it on fire like a peasant?
It is on fire, but it is still moving. Now it's starting to move towards you, which means re-roll that damage at the end of this turn.
Is it
going to
spread the fire? Is it...
I'm gonna take another couple of pot shots at it.
Alright.
The Alchemist Fire basically lights anything up that's flammable.
20 non-natural to hit on the first one.
Okay, it hits.
Okay. By the way, okay, wait, this is a +2 longbow, so what does that mean exactly?
+2 to hit.
+2 to hit, okay. And that's already factored into the 11 that's here, right?
Yes.
Okay, never mind then.
So yeah, every round it would take 5d4 unless it takes the time to put it out.
Yeah.
DC 10 dexterity to extinguish the flames.
10 piercing.
All right. So once again, the arrow gets sucked into the black pudding as it's on fire, but the arrow definitely hurt it.
Take another one. It's a 17 to hit.
That hits.
Okay.
Pew, 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 pew,
pew, pew, pew. 12 piercing.
All right.
Pip, pip.
Once again, the arrow sucks into it, and it definitely hits. It's going to try and extinguish. It does.
Oh, no.
But it will be on fire until the end of this round.
Okay. I was gonna say, like, it can take the it takes the 5d4 at the beginning of the round, and it can use its round to try and extinguish the fires if it wants to.
Okay, so I'll say it tried to.
Okay.
It extinguishes.
Okay.
Because it got lucky, but it can't attack.
Okay. Now who's next?
Right, next.
I think it's that's not
me.
You.
I think that may actually be me.
I'm last. Yeah, you're before. You're third.
Da 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 da. All right. So first of all. When you're resisting a fear effect, what do you use for your saves?
Wisdom, I think.
But, nat 20. Sweet. He is no longer shook.
Alright.
Alright.
He no longer shook.
I am going to fucking lay another scorching rain to this ooze. Because fuck that. 21 to hit.
Hit!
Do you need my d6s?
4, 6. Yeah, I need 4d6. There we go. Kazoush.
Ooh.
It's like a big old handful of dice.
Such high rolls.
Okay, so 5, 10, 16, 17.
We're going to make creme brulee 20, out of this pudding. 26, 27, 28, 29,
creme
30,
brulee sounds 31, really 30, nice right now.
33
actually.
Altogether.
Not black sauropod.
Once again, brulee. Basically, you boil this thing into oblivion. So you hit it with your scorching ray, it starts to bubble, and eventually bursts with a sickeningly disgusting smell.
Just like souffle.
Gross.
What are you gonna do now, guys?
I'm still raging, so I'm gonna smash through the door that the ooze
All right,
was
you
blocking.
Smash through the door at the end of the hallway. You enter this huge library. All of its lights are still on. Like, all of its torches are still lit. There's, like, a water fountain near the beginning. of the room. I guess you can wash your hands, sort of thing.
Don't.
Tons and tons of books. There's all. It's obviously some kind of an alchemist laboratory as well.
You're like fucking Groot. Don't drink from that. It's gross.
I have a water skin if you're that thirsty.
What? You're trying to pretend like you didn't do it. Why you lie to me?
All right. I guess I exit my rage and I take a 1 point of exhaustion. Oh, no. Well, the frenzy didn't. Well, just because it didn't happen doesn't mean I didn't declare it. So
I'm going to quickly mention to everybody, touch nothing. We have no idea if touching something in here is going to, like, curse us or cause some kind of problem. There's
always
a lot
with
of
the
shit
cursing.
Hand check.
Yes.
Hmm? It's a hand check, just like at the, never mind.
Yeah,
I don't want to go down that
I don't
road.
Even know what. Okay.
So, perception checks on the room then, Dad?
Yep.
Perception checks on the room.
15.
Actually, before that, everybody roll a wisdom.
What's the point in me rolling a wisdom? Okay. 14.
6.
17.
10. Calder, you seem to remember the Vistani woman mentioning something about a book in here.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
The flesh book.
The fucking a book bound in
human
flesh.
The one, yeah, the one probably screaming.
Close enough.
Okay, so right, yeah, no, that's right. The Vistani woman was talking about, in her vision, there was a book bound in human flesh somewhere in here. A bunch of kids who'd gone blind or something.
Something about a hole.
And the ghost of the girl
gone
downstairs.
Blind or children with no eyes.
With no eyes, yeah. The ghost of the girl downstairs
which
had no eyes.
Already.
It is possible that everybody in this place is long dead and is now just haunted as fuck. All right. Spread out. Look for a book.
I rolled a 15 perception then to search for the book.
Looking for a book.
I would prefer, if possible, not to have to go alone, because I'm still very hurt.
All right, come with me.
Come with me if you want to leave.
Did anybody roll over a 17?
I just rolled an 18.
Okay, so looking through the books, it takes you probably about an hour. Nothing else comes down the hallway. In fact, you barricade the door.
Yeah.
You eventually find a book with a rather unusual texture.
Find any healing potions?
Gross.
There is a...
I have some.
No, you do find several potions, but you can't identify them.
Drink them all.
I just go to Ophelia. Drink touch, these.
Don't touch those.
Don't drink those. Poison.
Well, I mean, let's take them and
you find
identify
a book
them later.
No, don't tell them. Don't take anything yet. Wait until we figure this out, because odds are we could, like, oh, that's an interesting book, and then take something off the shelves that we're not supposed to grab, and then ghosts come out everywhere and kill us. They're already mad at us for being greedy, quote-unquote.
As you grab the book,
nothing but the lamp.
It has an unusual texture to its cover.
Okay.
It definitely feels like a hardened, sickly leather. There's also a face on the front of the book.
Mm.
Obviously no eyes or anything,
a
but
book bound in testicles.
It was a man at one point whose face is now eternally locked in a scream.
That's
the book
fucking
on the
terrifying.
Cover refers to itself as the Book of Erebus.
Book of Erebus, huh?
Hey, guys, look at me. I'm the Book of Erebus.
God damn it, Calder.
Moving up in the world.
Moving up in the world.
Okay.
Mom said I could read a book when I got older, but who's laughing now,
okay,
Mom?
Did you guys not hear that?
What?
Say again,
do
Nod.
Do not mock me.
Oh, wait.
Yeah, let's do things by the book here.
Okay, okay. Is the face on the book moving?
Yo,
he
yeah.
Just,
oh,
it's
right
to
at
you.
You
with these
no, I know, but I don't know if
eyes that seem like black ink and they're just continuously swirling.
Well, okay.
Welcome to the team.
Hello. Do I just call you Book of Ab? Or
Carl.
Do you have a name?
It doesn't answer.
Doesn't answer. Do you know anything about the state of this building right now?
It just laughs at you.
That's fair.
The book just starts. If it could have a hearty belly laugh, it would.
Okay. Fuck it. I'm going
to
open the book.
I would say stash it in your bag of holding and take it to the Vistani woman, but.
But, how
but
about that? Yeah.
We done goofed. I'm going to have a look in the book.
Now,
book,
everybody,
book look.
Roll me a wisdom check at DC 20.
Jesus.
Wow, that's not even possible. I have no modifier.
Thanks, Connell.
On that.
Yeah, I don't have that.
I rolled 3.
2.
I rolled 2.
Um, and it's just wisdom?
Just wisdom.
Okay. I rolled a 17, but...
With your modifiers?
I'm going to... Well, I don't have any modifiers for wisdom, but I'm going to fucking spend...
I don't think any of us do.
I'm going to blow a level 1 spell to give myself 2 sorcerer points back, and I'm going to spend them on bend luck to give myself an extra d4.
Okay.
Rolls 1.
I rolled a 2.
Oh.
So I'm up to 19. Wait. And then I will fucking, I don't give a shit. I will blow Tides of Chaos to give myself advantage on this, which is +3 on a skill check.
All right. All right, so.
You dick.
The sound of this book laughing at you, literally, if it's like the book knew if it could reach into your memory and touch you in your most private, intimate moment where you were your most vulnerable.
Gross.
That's what it did. You feel unbelievably shook up. Basically, tomorrow, you wake up with level 2 exhaustion from nightmares.
Okay, wait, so I needed a 20 DC in wisdom to know that?
No, that's what's going to happen to them. It doesn't happen to you.
Yeah, this doesn't affect you.
I was just like, the fuck, Tom?
You're like, Jesus Christ.
Okay, I just scowl at this book. Are there any lit fireplaces in here right now?
I'm just going to fucking throw the book in the fire. What is wrong?
I'm going to walk over to the fireplace and just kind of like hold it close to the fire and be like, eh? Who's laughing now?
What do you think birthed me?
Okay. Well, I'm going to flip open the pages and start looking through. I can speak common and primordial.
You can't read it.
I can't read that.
We've got someone who knows Infernal.
Yeah, I was going to say, Selshire, do you just kind of open the book and hold it up to you? Can you
roll
read this?
Selshire, you're going to roll wisdom again.
Yeah.
Because you know this book did this to you.
Yeah.
So roll against fear.
Fuck. With wisdom, right?
Yep. Okay.
You got 10 plus...
No,
what's your wisdom modifier? Nothing.
No one has a wisdom modifier.
No one does.
Yeah, nobody.
You're like, fuck that, not going near it, no way, no how.
Oh,
intimidate
man.
Me to do it again.
No.
I grab Selchar going, read the book!
Just, I've got persuasion.
Intimidation is like persuasion.
There, I have rolled up
to... with punching.
I have rolled up to a 20, a 20 altogether, in persuasion.
Okay. Roll play it out. All decide if it's successful.
Come on.
That's the best you've got. You're all the best you've got.
I can't. Quiffy, okay, look, it's just a book, and it's going to laugh at you, but it's just a book. It can't hurt you. It is just a...
Are you sure that laugh can't hurt me?
Shut up, Steve Book.
Steve Book.
You know what? I'm going to call you Percival, and that's what...
I want to read it, but, like, it's too much.
Okay, here's what we're going to do then. And he walks over to a table, and he puts it open on the table and kind of presses it down, so if the thing laughs, it's muffled and awful.
Too bad as such.
There, okay. It's less threatening now.
Okay.
And like,
I'm going to try. I want to try again.
I'll hold the book, and you just walk over and read it if you can.
Okay.
Yeah, we just see if it's in Infernal.
Okay.
Like, to see if you can understand it. Because if you can't, then it's pointless.
All right, so Selchar, you walk over. With your Infernal language skill, you're able to understand probably about a quarter of it. You understand a couple words here and there. A lot of it talks about demon lords, resurrection spells, stuff like that. A lot of weird names you've never heard of. You see Strahd's name pops up in there once or twice.
Resurrection spells.
You do see a lot of it referring to lichdom, though. And you also see a couple of passages that refer to the puzzle box.
Ooh. Okay.
So this does have the information we're after.
You know what would actually be really helpful right now? A paladin!
Or a book of holding. I mean a bag of holding.
A bag of holding. Bag of holding would be so great right now, I know. Okay. I don't even have enough money to fucking buy it. And we're not getting paid on this job because we're not getting a sealed letter says that we brought back this girl's. Because everyone's been dead in this place for fucking centuries, so that's great.
Let's
right,
just
cool.
Go back to the Fistani.
Yep. With this book.
Because we have the book now that has information on where we need to go, but we can only read parts of it. So I would say if we bring it back to the old lady, maybe she might be able to give us more information.
It might kill her, though.
It could kill her.
Yeah.
And then they're going to fucking put the curse on us again.
I would like for that not to happen, please.
They're the closest thing we have to allies in this realm.
And
so.
it is literally the only path that we have to solving this realm and getting out.
Let's bind the book up in lots of leather.
I got some silk rope.
We can't hear it talk. We can't hear it move. It tape its mouth shut, whatever it takes. And I want to leave.
No.
You're not letting me touch anything. I can't smash anything.
I know. But here's the thing. Like,
I'm going to have 3 exhaustion in the morning.
Yeah. There is a possibility that if we take shit off of the shelves here, that we'll be fine. But there's also a greater possibility that touching anything in here is going to kill you. And the rest of us.
Okay, so the job's bunk again.
Yep.
There's no point in staying here.
No. The first job was not bunk. We got paid on the first job.
Yeah, we also got conned on the first job.
We also did get kind of, well, no, they just told us to take the body to the lake so that they could perform rites on her, which
so
they did.
So they could then resurrect her from the dead to declare war on Strahd.
Fucking poor Thumper. He's which, just like,
though,
I'm so sick of
fair,
all this shit.
Strahd von Zarevich is also the bad guy of this realm.
To be fair, we were lured into this realm on false pretenses and now we can't leave and go home.
Yes. You're acting like I'm not in this boat.
let's get off this boat.
I'm in this boat, dude. We can't. There's no getting off this boat. Okay, we gotta wait. We gotta wait until we get there. And I know this sucks.
I rage and smash the table.
But don't break shit.
The book goes, I take it you would like to leave at some point?
Nobody asked you, Steve.
Shut up, you book.
Hey, no, shut up.
Were you talking to the book or
don't,
us?
You guys. It might actually have something useful to say.
All right. Yes. We are looking to leave this realm.
Break the curse.
Everyone tells us that. We know that.
Okay, calm your shit,
Do you
please.
Know what curse you're breaking, though?
As far as we can tell, Strahd has a curse upon the land that keeps people bound here.
Oh, no, I'm not talking about that one. Even I can't do that.
You're talking about the curse on this place.
Are you talking about the curse on this building specifically?
Yeah, otherwise you're never going to leave and you will literally
yeah, we
be
can't
dead
even,
by dawn.
We can't even leave the keep.
Hold on, if we don't get out of here by dawn, are we going to
probably die?
Turn into these people?
How is it we would get out of this keep
likely.
Then? How do we get out of the keep?
How do we return
the body
the
to where it's supposed to be?
We lost the body, and we brought it back to the keep like they were supposed to. Is the body not supposed to be brought here?
It is, but you don't leave bodies in the middle of a room.
It was
you put
gone.
Them with their families in the crypt.
But the body vanished when we went to reveal it.
Well, you put it down and now it's gone apparently. So, do you know
was
where the
taken?
Body is?
He says the Book of Erebus says with just a hint of malice, well, I'd go looking in the crypt. If the body's there, find it, destroy it,
put it with its family.
Presumably everything goes back to normal. And then I can
I still
this
have 5 vials of alchemist fire.
So I have an interest in seeing you succeed.
Okay.
Okay, because then you're also stuck in this building, I guess, eh?
Oh, I've been here for untold years.
And cool. and everybody in this keep's been dead this entire time?
Oh, yes. Well, occasionally we get new visitors whenever the traps, so to speak, lead them in. In fact,
oh, that's the girl.
I'm guessing you weren't the only group that was invited here.
No, we were not.
Well, the first ones to get back here, though.
This is a giant honey trap.
Oh, no, they were here days before you were.
Oh, crumbs. Yeah, because
time doesn't seem to work in Ravenloft, as you outsiders are not familiar
perceive
with.
It. Right, okay.
All right, so next week we're going to the crypt.
Now, this is the Book of what?
Erebus.
How do you spell that?
Erebus.
That's what I thought.
All right. Do you know where the crypt is in this place? Can you lead us there?
Right there in the back. down the stairs.
Cool. If we try, to break the curse, can you please stop scaring us, please? you're scaring.
Oh, where's the fun in that?
We'll just find.
It makes it really hard to help you. If you just
we'll just find a new bag.
Stuck. I've been here for centuries before. What's a few more? You're just the ones that have gotten this far.
Anybody else get this far?
Once. I'm sure you'll run into them at some point.
Book of Erebus.
Oh, okay, good.
If I understand attempting to take anything from this place results in punitive measures on the part of the keep. Am I correct?
For the most part.
Okay.
But not always. There are treasures here you can take. It's just, can you find the right ones?
God, I hate these riddles.
Great.
Okay, so basically, don't bother taking shit.
Yep. Okay.
Let's just
go to the crypt, smash and burn everything.
Well, let's wait until the curse is lifted, and then if there's any shit left over after that, then we can, like, and if there's anybody even alive here, then we'll deal with it.
Chances are, when the curse is lifted, this whole crypt is gonna vanish. This whole keep.
Yeah.
Turn into ruins.
That's okay.
And everything we've picked up is gonna vanish as well. So we'll deal with it after. All right. Let's go to the crypt.
How are we doing for time, Justin?
We're done.
All right, perfect. And find out what happens as they descend into the forbidden crypt where what allows them?
This sounds like a great idea,
I don't
guys.
Know that. So, for terrible warriors, this has been Ravenloft, Dead by Dawn's Light. We have been...
Justin!
Look at me!
Look at me! Gooey! Oh boy. See you next time.
I'm Scott, playing Salshar, who finally shot his crossbow. After what is it? Like
it for the best good. Damage ever.
11 episodes.
Good. 11 it episodes.
True damage.
Come back. Which
is like the corner of my hammer.
An insect's fart in the face of Christ the Redeemer.
Christ, Connell.
And I have been Connell Macbeth, better known in the nerd community as Toronto's greatest supervillain and evil genius, Dr. Terawatt, playing Calder, the Pyromancer.
And I've been Mike the Birdman Dodd from ThisWeekInGeek.net, and I have been the bringer of their destruction.
Cassie!
Next week.
Stop, Cassie!
Cassie!
Nope.
Okay.
You dick.
You dick.
All right.
And I'm Cassie D20 Love Chew. Thank you for tuning in with us, being probably hopefully equally as horrified as we are.
And join us next time where we all die in a crypt and Steve Saylor returns to an empty campaign.
He like comes back from his
meditation
in
the forest, be like, where'd everyone go?
Unless he's
all
meditating
dead.
In the crypt.
They're all, oh, fuck. We're gonna find him. He's gonna be like, he's the dark lord of the crypt, isn't he?
He's the boss.
You know, because time doesn't work in Ravenloft. What if Stieg is the Book of Erebus?
Oh, fuck.
He's like the face of Bo and Captain Jack kind of thing.
That's awful. Anyways.
Anyways.
See you next time.
Till next time.
Bye.
Bye, everybody.
Pew! Oh boy, don't think they're gonna get out of that one this time. Spooky stuff. In fact, I don't even know what happens next because that's all we recorded. We'll have more episodes recorded soon. We're recording more Ravenloft this month. We just do them in batches like that, and every now and then we hit a part where we don't know what comes next. I mean, Mike has his ideas of what comes next, but if Connell has anything to say about it, we'll probably end up blowing stuff up. And if you never want to see an adventurer lose their bag of holding again, you too can adopt a Terrible Warrior today by visiting our Patreon page at patreon.com/terriblewarriors. Thanks to you, you have supported us for the full 2 months we've been using Patreon. We've been able to cover all of our operating costs, get music licensing for the show, as well as being able to help pay for the campaign costs of running these programs. That is thanks to you, and thank you so much. And while Ravenloft may be going on pause for now, you can rest assured that there are still new episodes of The Terrible Warriors every Thursday and every Monday. And if you return on Thursday, Derek the Bard and his Edmonton crew bring together a new campaign they're calling Lasers and Feelings. I've been told this one's weird, so buckle up
and on Monday, another new campaign for you. The first episode in a one-shot we are calling Dogs in the Vineyard, Gold Rush. It's another Western game, I know, right on the heels of Deadlands, but I gotta tell you, it had one of the coolest dice mechanics I've ever used on this show. I kind of want to find a way to use those dice in another game. And after you listen to it, you'll understand why I want that other game to be Star Wars. Speaking of Star Wars, we've recorded new episodes of Embers of the Jedi, and they're ready and in line. They're coming out in December. We wanted to tie that in with Rogue One because we're savvy like that. And you can follow us online for all the updates on Twitter at Dice Warriors. You can find us on Facebook. We do stuff there too. And on Patreon at patreon.com/terriblewarriors. Today's Terrible Warriors were Mike the Birdman Dodd, Cassie Chu, Connell Macbeth, Scotty Bordas, Justin Eacock. The art was by Steve Saylor, and the music of the Ravenloft Dead by Dawn's Light campaign is by Tom He's an Evil Genius White. We're making music in-house now. Ta-da! Thank you for listening, for sharing, for reviewing, for playing your games and telling your stories and rolling your dice, because goddamn, this is a fun hobby. Just for that, you are a terrible warrior.